basic geometrical ideas. See the second question. In the given diagram, name the points. In the given diagram, name the points in the interior of triangle, interior of angle DOE. In the interior of angle DOE, DOE, and in the exterior of angle EOF, angle EOF, and the third one on angle EOF. So what we have to do in the given diagram? Name the points. Name the points in the angle, in the interior of angle DOE. Interior means inside. Exterior means outside. Clear? Understood? So in the interior of angle DOE. So now see the angle. Angle DOE. So this is angle, right? DOE angle. In this, which point you can see inside the angle? That point is the A. Correct? The point A is inside the angle DOE. Okay? The first one answer. In the interior of angle DOE is a point A. Clear? Let's write the sentence. Point A. Clear? Question is the interior of angle. Now you have to see the figure. That angle is DOE. Angle DOE, the interior angle, that interior point is A. Clear? Interior point is A. Now second one. In the exterior of angle EOF. So which is the angle EOF? This is EOF. So in this angle, in the angle EOF, in the angle EOF, so which is the exterior angle? Exterior means outside the angle. So in this EOF, you see, is there any interior angles? No. They asked right exterior angle of EOF. That is, one is F, the point F, A and D. Clear? These points are outside the angle of EOF. Sorry, this is F, right? This point is F. See, angle EOF, outside we can see this point. That is C, A and B. So therefore, second one answer, in the exterior of angle EOF, the points are C. C is outside the angle. Correct? So this is outside the angle. This point also outside the angle. And then point D also outside the angle. That three points are outside the exterior of angle EOF. The EOF. So first we have to see the figure and then something following. Clear? So now third one. On BEOF. On EOF. Angle EOF means the points on EOF. That is the B. So this point B is on the angle EOF. Fifth point the B. Point B is on the angle EOF. Clear? So this is the answer. The second question is here. Draw an sketch of triangle ABC. Mark a point P in its interior and a point Q in its exterior or in its interior. Clear? So now what you have to do? First you have to draw a rough sketch of a triangle ABC. Okay? You can draw a triangle. Then you can name this as A. This is B and this is a C. So ABC is a triangle. ABC is a triangle. So in this, the mark a point P. Mark a point P in its interior. So P is a point. You have to mention inside the triangle. So P is inside the triangle. And a point Q in its exterior. Exterior means outside the triangle. So now you can represent this point Q outside the triangle. Maybe here also you can write the Q on here. Clear? So Q is what? Exterior. Exterior point. Correct? Q is the exterior point. P is inside the triangle. Interior. Clear? First draw a sketch of triangle. Then you have to mark a point P in its interior and a point Q in its exterior or in its interior. Clear? Understood? So just not represent like this. If they ask to represent it on triangle, then just try here on a cube. Point on a triangle. Here they have to write inside. Interior means inside, exterior outside. Clear? Yes. Okay, the next question is identify three triangles in the figure. Identify three triangles in the figure. And second one, write the names of seven angles. Write the names of seven angles and write the names of six line segments. And the fourth question, which two triangles have angle B as common? Clear? The first question, see the figure and you have to answer the following questions. Clear? The first question is, you have to write the triangles, identify three triangles. Identify three triangles. One triangle is the ABD triangle and another triangle is ADC triangle. Clear? So this triangle, ABD triangle, and another one ADC triangle, and one more triangle, that is B triangle, ABC triangle. Clear? So there are three triangles now. One is the ADC, ABD triangle, one more triangle ADC triangle, and another triangle is a ABC, that is big triangle. So if you don't consider this line segment, if you don't consider this line, then you will get one triangle. It's a big triangle, that is a ABC triangle. Clear? So now we can see ABD triangle, ADC triangle, and ABC triangle. ADC, ABC triangle. So now second question. Write the names of seven angles. How many angles are? Seven angles are. See now, right? Seven angles. One angle is a. See, if you see ADB triangle, in ADB triangle there are three angles, right? Three angles are. So first angle, that is, if you are considering angle A, if you are considering angle A, then how to write BAD. Clear? Angle BAD. That means, which angle you are considering? Angle A. That should be the middle. Clear? So BAD. Over. Next, we are considering angle B. That is ABD. Angle ABD. Okay? Next, one more angle. ADB. So angle D. Now we are considering angle D. So now how we can read? ADB. ADB angle. So three angles in our triangle ADB. And now again, three angles are there in ADC triangle also, right? Now if you consider ADC triangle, so tell me the angles of this angle. In this triangle, B, ADC, angle ADC, another one, angle A, so how to read this? DAC or CAD. Okay? DAC. See the figure and write the angles. Next, remaining one angle, that is C. How to read? DCA or ACD. ACD. In the second triangle. In the first triangle, you got these angles. Second triangle, ADC triangle, these three angles. Now, one more triangle is there. That is a ABC triangle, we get a this angle. So if you don't consider this line segment, we get one angle, right? That is BAC, angle BAC, angle BAC. Okay? So these are angles in this triangle, seven angles. Now you have to write line segment. How many line segments are there? Write the names of six line segments. Now see the triangle and you write the line segment. Write the names of six line segments. One is AB, line segment AB, and BD, BD is another line segment. Line segment means it has two end points. So in AB, the end points are, one is A, another end point is B. Clear? So AB is one line segment and BD, BD is another line segment. So B is a pointer, B is a point. So BD is a line segment. Clear? The next line segment is a AD. So AD is a line segment. So write AD. Next BC is another line segment. Then AC is a one more line segment. How many line segments are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So here they are to write 6 line segments. So So now you can consider BC is a line segment. You don't consider this point. Then what you can say? BC is a line segment. So right, BC is also line segment. Line segment understood? It has a two end points. We cannot extend these points. Lines clear? So this is what a line segment. Now, last one. Which two triangles have angle B as common? In which two triangles, if you consider any two triangles, the angle B must be common. So say, angle B is a common both the triangle, two triangles. Which triangle? Now, if you see the figure, you can understand that angle triangle ABD, triangle ABD and ADC is the angle B. In ABD triangle, we get angle B. Is there B in angle ADC? Triangle ADC? No. Angle B we cannot see in this triangle. Yeah? Only in a ABD triangle and one more triangle, ABC triangle. One is big triangle, ABC. That angle B is there, right? So similarly, in ABD triangle, we can see angle B. So angle B is common in triangle. Angle B is common in triangle ABD and then one triangle ABC. Okay? So these two triangles are in two triangles we can see that angle B as a common. Clear? The question understood? Which two triangles have angle B as common? One is triangle ABD and triangle ABC. Clear? Okay? The next question is, draw a rough sketch of quadrilateral. So you have to draw a quadrilateral shape, that is a PQRS. PQRS is a quadrilateral. Then what you have to do? Draw its diagonals. You have to draw diagonals of a quadrilateral PQRS. Then name them. Next up, is a meeting point of the diagonals in the interior or a exterior of the quadrilateral. Clear? Now we have to draw a rough diagram, then you have to check the diagonals are intersecting. Diagonals will meet at one point. That point is appearing inside the quadrilateral or outside the quadrilateral, interior or exterior. Clear? That you have to see. So now first up, you have to draw the rough sketch, rough diagram of a quadrilateral. So which quadrilateral you have to draw? That is a PQRS quadrilateral. No, there are many types of quadrilateral. It may be square, rectangle, trapezium or parallelogram, rhombus. These are comes under quadrilateral. Clear? That means four-sided polygon. What is quadrilateral? This is a four-sided polygon. Clear? So is it, this is closed figure? Yes, this is a closed figure. This is a polygon. Clear? So polygon having how many sides? Four sides. This is quadrilateral. Clear? Closed figure, or we can say that polygon or a quadrilateral. It's not mentioned the square, rectangle, clear, or a trapezium, but just they asked to draw a rough diagram of quadrilateral PQRS. So you can name this as P, this point is P, and this point is Q, and this is R, and this is a S. So PQRS is a quadrilateral. So what you have to draw? You have to draw its diagonal. How many diagonals can be drawn? There are two diagonals. One is the SQ is a diagonal, another one is a PR. Only two diagonals can be drawn in this quadrilateral. Understood? Which are all diagonals? One is a PR diagonal and a SQ. Two diagonals. In a quadrilateral PQRS, SQ is one diagonal, PR is another diagonal. Clear? So these two diagonals will intersect at one point, correct? So these two diagonals will intersect at one point. This point is a O. Clear? So now we can say that this point is appearing inside the quadrilateral, means interior of the quadrilateral, not exterior, right? This point we can see inside the quadrilateral. Understood? So what is the question? It's very simple. Just you have to draw quadrilateral PQRS. Then you have to draw diagonals. Then you have to see whether diagonals are intersecting inside the quadrilateral or outside. Means interior or exterior. So we can see that the diagonals will bisect each other, intersecting each other at one point four, that is the interior inside the quadrilateral. Okay, is clear? Yes. The second question. See here, draw rough sketch of quadrilateral KLMN. So here we have to draw another quadrilateral, that is the KLMN quadrilateral. Then what you have to do? State two pairs of opposite sides, two pairs of opposite angles, and two pairs of adjacent sides, and two pairs of adjacent angle. Clear? So first you have to draw quadrilateral shape. Clear? Yes. You see now. Draw quadrilateral, that is the KLMN. KLMN. So if you name this point is K, and this is the L, this point is M, and this point is the N. Okay, KLMN is a quadrilateral. So first what you have to write? Two pairs of opposite sides. So now in the quadrilateral, opposite sides. So first we'll see how many sides are there. There are four sides in this quadrilateral, correct? One is a KL and LM, another one MN and a KN. So there are four sides. In that, what we have to write? First you have to write two pairs of opposite sides. Two pairs of opposite sides. One side is your KL. So this KL, which is the opposite side, that is MN. Okay? KL opposite side is a MN. So first one answer KL and MN are opposite sides. KL and MN, this is one pair. Now one more opposite side is for KN, the opposite side is a MN, correct? This side is opposite to this side. That means KN is opposite to another side is a LM. Clear? So these are opposite pair of opposite sides. Clear? So now second question. Two pairs of opposite angle. So you know angle. In how many angles we can see in quadrilateral? There are four angles. One is angle K, angle L, angle M, and angle N. So there are four angles in a quadrilateral. But what we have to write? We have to write two pairs of opposite angle. It's very simple. So now angle N, which is opposite angle? That is angle L. Clear? So angle N is opposite to angle L. And similarly, angle K is opposite to angle M. Okay? Now second one answer is a angle N is angle N and angle L is are opposite angles. Clear? So these are opposite angles. And remaining angle K and angle M are opposite angles. Second one. Now the third one question is two pairs of adjacent sides. Adjacent means near. See, for KL, which is adjacent to KL. So these two sides are adjacent sides. Okay. Similarly, you can consider KL and MN. So these two sides also adjacent sides. For this adjacent side is a MN and ML are adjacent sides. But how many adjacent sides you have to write? Only two pairs of adjacent sides. So if I consider KL and ML, so these two sides are adjacent sides. So I will write KL and LM. LM, or you can say ML. Okay? You can write LM or MN. So these two sides are adjacent sides. Similarly, we can say that MN, this side, MN and KN. Is it correct? Yes, KN are adjacent sides. So MN, or you can say that NM, comma, another one, KN are adjacent sides. Two pairs of adjacent sides. Now fourth question, see that two pairs of adjacent angle. Two pairs of adjacent angle. So that means, see the adjacent angle. From angle K, the adjacent angle is L. Clear? Or you can say that angle K adjacent is the angle M. Or for this angle M is adjacent. But for angle M, angle K is adjacent. Angle M is adjacent. So So now we have to write two pairs of adjacent angles. So now angle K and angle L are adjacent. Similarly, angle M and angle N are adjacent. If you want, you can consider these two, and these two are adjacent angles. Clear? So first you have to draw rough diagram of quadrilateral. Then you have to name that. The name of the quadrilateral is given in the question. That is which quadrilateral? K L M N. K L M N quadrilateral. In the article you have to mention two pairs of opposite sides, two pairs of opposite angles, and two pairs of adjacent sides, and two pairs